Breathing is very essential to our health. I'm going to show you how to overclock the oxygen level inside of your body. This is something a friend of mine's, we do during days. We don't work out during the holidays and instead do this instead. So the way you want to start off is just completely relax, and your hands on your belly button. Now you want to take deep breaths to fill it all in. We're going to do 10 of those. So it's that was two. Four. Six. Eight. That's 10. This is so important because for me as an entrepreneur, investment business person, I always want to make sure I'm at top shape to perform, get my mind stress level to be reduced, to be able to execute. This is very crucial for your well-being. So now that we're completely relaxed, now you can put your hands on your sides completely. Now you should start feeling your head feel a little bit of wooziness, but shouldn't be too bad yet. All right. So now this first one that we're going to do, we're going to do the inhales and increments from 1 through 5. And I'm going to explain that. So pretty much you do 1 and then you exhale and you do it twice, inhale, and then you exhale. And then you do 3 times, and then you exhale. We're gonna go all the way up to 5, and then we're gonna take a break, and then we're gonna do it in reverse. So we're gonna do it on the exhale this time. So, ready? Let's go. Relax now, dip up to 5. Did you feel your head a little woozy? It's just overclocking your oxygen level inside of your body. Now we're gonna do it in reverse. So it's gonna be 1 inhale and then 1 exhale. 1 inhale, then 2 exhale. Then 1 inhale and then 3 exhale. Right? So we're gonna go all the way to 5. Let's go. 1 inhale. 5. There we go. Now it's time for the sprints. So the sprints, you're pretty much doing 3 second intervals of inhales, then exhale. So you do 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So inhale and exhale, but you're doing it 3 seconds at a time. And we're going to try to go all the way up to 15. All right, so let's go. We're on 5. Ten. plus 15. If you want to relax, you should feel the tingling inside of your body. This is just you getting a lot more oxygen into your body. Breathe at normal pace. Breathe at normal pace. I usually do this on an empty stomach before doing anything, because I don't want nothing to come out. If anything, I just have like a sip of water, like one sip before I start this exercise, and that's it. Alright. We're going to do this last sprint. We're going to go up to 10. Okay. Ready? Let's go. This time we're gonna do two counts, so it's gonna be real fast. And we're just gonna go up to 10. It's gonna be 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Alright. And it's all from your nose. You're not using your mouth at all. Let's go. This time, you're gonna hold the last one. After you get to 10, do a big breath and just hold it. Just hold that one, do not exhale, just hold it. Exhale. Breathe slow from your nose. Slow. Just imagine the waters, imagine the sea, the breeze, the trees, the leaves. Now you can slowly get up as you need to, pretty much. So this was just a shortened version of this. We would typically go up to like 10, and then we also probably go up to 30, and then the last breath we hold is probably for 2 minutes. What you probably notice is when you overclock that oxygen, the last breath I told you to hold, you didn't feel it as much. Usually when people ask you to hold your breath, you just holding it, you feel like you're going to pass out after like maybe 30 seconds. But because you had so much oxygen inside of your body, you're able to hold your breath a lot much more longer, which lets you just propel. So it's a good exercise to do probably before you go dive deep in the water to just help your oxygen level be at a much higher pace. And people who are natural swimmers, you notice that they have high stamina and they also are able to hold their breath a lot longer because they're doing this quite often when they're inside of the water. And they're doing a constant overclocking of the oxygen level inside of their body. So this is a good way to relieve stress, anxiety, and help you start your day. We don't do this all the time. It's not something I recommend you do every single day, of course, but do it once in a while to really help you reset and relieve some of that stress, anxiety, especially for my entrepreneurs, business owners out there. This is how I'm starting my day today. Peace and love, trust in Jesus. Have an amazing one. Hustle, hustle, hustle.